Hello and welcome to Take a Bite. Today I'm going to show you the healthiest version of plum cake or the Christmas cake. And this is free of refined sugar, refined flour, no eggs, no butter. So that will be perfect for the vegan and kids also. And this is the treat for the diabetic patient also, because here I have used the date syrup to make this cake. So this is the healthiest cake I have ever made. So let's see what we will need. So first of all, we will soak our assorted nuts or the dry fruits. So here I have taken the black currants, then black raisins, you can take golden also, chopped up prunes, 2 tablespoons. All the fruits are taken into the quantity of 2 tablespoons, red cherries, chopped up. Then 1 cup of orange juice. You can choose apple juice, grape juice, or if you want to go for alcoholic version, you can use a brandy, wine or rum also. So here I have taken 2 tablespoons of Tutti, Futti or the Candid fruits, 2 tablespoons of dried cranberries. So you can choose any nut or fruit of your choice, and the quantity you can vary according to your liking. So adding all the dry fruits into the bowl, and we have to soak this for at least for about 48 hours. You can soak it for longer for more tastier version. You can soak it for about 15 days. So here I'm adding the orange juice. In the alcoholic version, alcohol act as the preservative for these nuts and the fruits, but in case of the orange juice, we have to keep an eye on it and we cannot keep it for longer soaking period. So here I have kept it for 48 hours only, and now we will keep it aside for 48 hours and then we will take it out. So let's move to the cake ingredients and see what we will need. So for the sweetener, I am using 1/2 cup of date paste. You can take 20 to 25 pitted dates. 20 will be good enough because we are adding our fruits and nuts also. They are also sweet. So, and here I have taken 1 1/4 cup of warm milk. All the details of ingredients will be listed in the description box down below. So here we have taken 1 cup of whole wheat flour and 1/3 cup of the chopped up nuts, in which I have taken almonds, pistachios and cashews. 1 tablespoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, pinch of salt, and here we will use the zest of orange, that will be 1/4 teaspoon, and 1/2 cup of oil, 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder, and in spices we have taken 1/4 cup teaspoon of allspice and 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon powder, and we will use the nutmeg powder also. So we will grate at the time of the mixing the cake. And can you see, the all the nuts and the fruits has been soaked up nicely. All the juices has been taken up by the nuts and fruits, and they swell in the size and no juices are left inside. So we will keep it aside, and now we will strain our dry ingredients. So here I'm adding whole wheat flour and some of few I'm keeping to coat the nuts, and adding all the dry ingredients, cocoa powder, and all the spices we are adding here. You can use the clove powder instead of allspice. And here I'm grating some nutmeg, 1/4 teaspoon. Now we will sift our flour mixture. All the dry ingredients will be sifted well and it become airy. As we are using the whole wheat flour, it should rise much, and because of this straining, that will get some aeration, so it will rise up well. So now we will keep it aside, and now we will coat our dry fruits with 1 tablespoon of flour mixture, and now we will keep aside too. Work on the liquid ingredients. So to the milk, I am adding here 1/2 cup of date paste. If you do not find the date paste, you can use the 20 to 25 pitted dates. 25 will be too much, I guess, because of we are using the dry fruits and nuts also. They are also sweeter in taste, so go with 20 dates and soak them for about 4 to 5 hours and then use it for this recipe. So here I am mixing the date paste well in the warm milk. Warm milk helps to mix it well. You can run this mixture through the mixer grinder also. So now I got the nice paste and now I am mixing it well once again. And to that we will add our half a cup of oil and we will mix it well. And now to that I am adding the floured dried nuts. And here I am grating the zest of the orange and you can take a zest of lemon also, but here I am using the orange zest only. The upper orange portion you have to peel, don't go for the white one, it will be bitter. So I am grating here about 1/4 teaspoon. You can add more quantity if you like more. And now adding all the soaked up dry fruits and nuts into the batter. And now we have to mix our ingredients one more time really well. And we will add the dry ingredients which we have sifted in two batches. Don't add all at a time. And mix it well. So our batter is now looks good to me. If it looks more thicker to you, this batter is quite thicker in nature as compared to other cake batters. But if you find it more thicker inside, so you can use few tablespoons of orange juice or the milk also. So here I need to add, I need to add 2 to 3 tablespoons of orange juice. Yes, it is quite thick. So here I will add the 2 to 3 tablespoons of orange juice and we will mix it well. And now the cake batter looks perfect to me. Because of adding the cocoa powder, it gives nice color to the batter, blackish color to the cake. Or instead of juice, you can use the caramel sugar also for soaking the nuts and fruits. That will also give the nice color to it. And now I have taken a greased baking tray in which I have added the parchment paper at the base also and on the sides also, and keep it little higher because we have to bake the cake and for about 40 to 45 minutes or even for 1 hour. So here I have kept it somewhat longer than the cake tin height. So it is greased well with the olive oil. Now we will add our cake batter inside, and I have already preheated the oven at 350 Fahrenheit for about 15 minutes. And now I'm adding all the cake batter inside and we will level it well. And we will bake it in the preheated oven for about 40 to 45 minutes. And now keep an eye after 45 minutes whether it is done or not by inserting a toothpick. If it comes out clean, then it is done, or otherwise you will bake for 10 more minutes. So here my cake took about 55 minutes to bake, and we will insert the skewer and see whether it is done or not. So skewer come out clean, so it's done. So we will keep it as it is for about 10 minutes and then we will open it. Now 10 minutes are done, we will open it. Isn't it look gorgeous? who can say it is made up of so many clean ingredients. So this is the healthiest cake I ever baked. So now I will decorate it, and before decorating you should make sure that it is cooled down completely. So adding few cherries over it, and we will decorate it with the icing sugar. And now I will cut it and show you how it turned out. So it turned out awesome, and it looks gorgeous to me. And do try this awesome recipe this Christmas and let me know how it turned out for you. Thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to Take a Bite. Thank you so much. Stay tuned, stay hungry.